video is about everything that I'm returning to Victoria's Secret. As you can see, I have quite a few products I didn't like, I know that I will not use, so I won't be keeping them. I actually will not be keeping all four of the new summer line, so Golden Sands was very offensive. It had a lot of amber and a lot of sea salt, but it was just really strong. Secret Sunrise, I did like this one. It was really the only one that I liked out of the four, but it's a little too basic for me. I have a bunch of scents that smell just like it, so there's nothing in me that wants to pick this over the others, so away it goes. Island Away is another one I'm returning. I thought it was a fun, fruity, sunblocky coconut, but once I sprayed it on my skin, it smelled good for a couple seconds and then it turned musky. And Hot Florals was the last one, but I do not have that anymore because me and my mom did a little swaparoo. I'm trying to get her into Victoria's Secret scents now because she loves Bath & Body Works. And she really liked Hot Florals. That was her favorite out of the ones that I didn't like, so she wound up keeping that one. On my skin, it smells like a banana, coconut, sunblocky, a little bit musky, almost like that other one, Island Away. Then we have the Radiant Collection, and the only one out of that that I will not be keeping is Pure Seduction Radiant. It was just a little bit too tangy. I did not have one day where I wanted to wear this, where I even thought about it. So even though I like it and I think it's a really nice scent, I can't keep it because I'm not gonna use it.
Duh.
Now, these ones are from my latest haul. I did a first impressions video on these and I just wanted to follow up so you guys knew what I really thought. I didn't review all of these yet. I'm getting around to the La Creme and Super Flora line. I only got these two La Creme sprays, Velvet Petals and Pure Seduction, and unfortunately, I do not vibe with either of them. I don't think they're bad scents. I don't think any of the ones that I don't like are bad scents. They're just not my style. But if I had to pick out of the two, Velvet Petals, I actually took a little bit to make a decision on because it smells a lot like the original Velvet Petals, which I love, but it just has a little more of a floral note to it. I don't own the original Velvet Petals. I own Velvet Petals Radiant, which also smells like the original. So that's enough Velvet Petals for me. If I want something like that, I can reach for the Radiant Velvet Petals, not La Creme. Again, winter scents really aren't my thing. These were a winter line. Although they weren't as warm and creamy as I thought, they're just not my style. Eternal Sunflower is another one I'm not keeping. It actually smells really good from the nozzle and when you spray it on a little tester square paper. I sprayed it on my mom and I was like, wow, this smells a lot better on you than it does on me.
Wah, wah, wah.
So my body chemistry just does not like this one. It's a little bit too warm and floral for me, but it wasn't what I was expecting. I guess I have a different idea of what sunflower smells like, so I was expecting something a little bit sweeter, almost like a mimosa scent. So yeah, this one's a no. I tried to get my mom to take this one too, but she wasn't really a fan. Paradise Bloom, I am not keeping this. I realized that I don't like hibiscus scents, or at least most of them, and this reminds me too much of Bath & Body Works Hibiscus Paradise, which I also didn't like and I didn't keep, so yep, away it goes. Pink Fire is another one that I'm not keeping, and ironically, it is what I was supposed to gravitate towards, being a fire sign. Just way too warm and powdery for me. But if you've noticed, I did not put Pink Water in this bag, this return bag, because I don't think I can part with it. I love it. I think it's a really fresh vanilla and I'm probably gonna keep it. So last thing I will be returning is Calm Water. As much as I really liked this and thought it was a nice candy-like summer scent, it is just way too much for me. It's way too sweet. The lily kind of makes it even more just overbearingly sweet, and I like sweet things, but in the time that I had it, not one time was I like, oh, let me use Calm Water. It smelled good on my skin when I tried it, but after that I kind of forgot about it and never even really wanted to use it when I saw it, so I'll be returning this too. So that's it for my returns. Hopefully when they come out with some more products next time, I won't be returning so many. It is wasteful. I always feel really bad whenever I bring things in to return because I know that they get trashed. So I'm trying to find an alternative to returning them. With the coronavirus, it's hard to go in store and smell a fragrance through the mask and know if you like it. It's already hard enough to smell things in store without a mask. So for me, this is just the only way. And just because I'm returning these scents does not mean that they are not beautiful, unique scents. I think they are all great in their own way, and I'm sure that there is somebody out there that will love them for who they are, but that person is not me.